In this time of desperation, when all we know is doubt and fear.
Very good morning, beloved. It is Wednesday, 25th November, and I greet you in the wonderful name of Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen. The theme for the week is hope, and the sub-theme for today is my hope is in you, based on Psalm 39 verse 7. And the Lewis family is doing the devotion this morning. God bless you as you listen to this word and live according to it. Amen.
Good day, my name is Rochester Lewis.
And I'm Whitney Lewis. Today we'll be sharing the message of hope with you all. We hope that you enjoy.
Okay, so this is a confession I like to make. It's my acknowledgement, you know, that God's word is powerful and it's never changing. So it's just it serves as a reminder always. So normally what I do is I take my Bible and I hold it in my hand and I say, this is my Bible. I am what it says I am. I can do what it says I can do. I have what it says I have. Today I will be taught the word of God. I boldly confess, my mind is alert and my heart is receptive. I will never be the same. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. I will be sharing with you the scripture from Psalm 39 verse 7 from the New King James Version. And now, Lord, what do I wait for? My hope is in you. This is the word of the Lord.
Okay, so I just want to share my understanding of hope and basically what hope means to me. So we might have bad experiences, delays, disappointments, especially in these tough times when life doesn't make sense, when your prayers haven't been answered as quickly as you'd like it to. It's easy to throw in the towel and give up, but you have to make sure you keep your anchor of hope down and hope in the Lord. When you anchor to hope, God will make things happen to you that you would never make happen on your own. When you have your hope in Him, the scripture says you will never be disappointed. You might have temporary setbacks, but when it's all said and done, you come out better than you were before if you don't give up your hope in the Lord's promise. Romans 5 verse 5 says, and hope does not disappoint because the love of God has been poured out within our hearts through the Holy Spirit who was given to us.
Hey all, I greet you in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. My name is Whitney Lewis. I'll be bringing the message to you today. It's not really a sermon because I'm not really good at that, but I was so excited when I was given this theme. The theme being hope. The sub theme being my hope is in you. And I think what was so important about having hope this year especially excuse me, is because hope has been a very difficult thing for so many people to have, with 2020 being the way it is right now. So many have lost lives, have lost jobs, are going through probably what must be the worst financial situation that you can imagine all at once. Everything just seems to be happening at the same time. And so how is it that we are still expected to have hope in such a hopeless time? And one of the things that I struggled with even prior to this to this day was understanding the difference between hope and faith. You know, what is the difference between the two? And when I looked at the meaning, so I'd like to just share the meaning of hope with you from the dictionary, which is a feeling of expectation and desire for a particular thing to happen. And the direct meaning of faith is complete trust or confidence in something or someone, which we know is someone, right? And that just really put it into perspective for me, is that hope is actually our training for having faith in God. And so it is so important for us right now to practice keeping the faith, practice believing that we will see the change. One of the standout verses for me, apart from the scripture that we were given, Psalm 39 verse 7, which I shared with you earlier, is Hebrews 11 verse 1. That says, "Now faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen." And it's just such a big scripture in just simplifying what it is that God is expecting from us. It almost makes me, I don't know how many of you know Pastor Stephen Furtick is amazing. I often listen to his sermons, and one of the things that he spoke about when it comes to hope is that you will never be able to practice hope if you are not taken through a situation that requires hope. We have been placed in a hopeless situation so that we can not only hope for a better day, but believe that that better day will come and put our faith and trust in God. And so, in ending, it's just, I want to implore you to all remember that Psalm 121, the entire Psalm, but the verses that I want to share with you specifically, 1-2 speaks of a song of ascent. "I will lift my eyes to you, to the hills. From whence comes my help? My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth." And so my hope for each and every single one of you is that you place your faith in God and know that whatever situation you find yourselves in, whether it's COVID related or not, put your faith in God. Practice with a hope that you see for yourself, for your families, loved ones, your situation, and know that better days will come. Amen.
Let's close our eyes for the prayer. God, we firstly thank you for the opportunity to share your word, God. As we know your word will stay forever, we thank you for your grace. Lord, you remind us over and over in your word that you are always with us. You tell us not to fear, and you draw us into your presence. You are the only place we can find comfort in any way we might lack. We find peace and strength only in you, Lord. We ask moving forward today that your words of truth and power strengthen us in our hearts for your honor. We thank you for your goodness. We thank you that you know the way we take and that you have a plan for us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.